Welcome to Dahua Academy. Today we will learn how to configure the NVR failover configuration. Prerequisite you need. All NVR must be from same series. And should be updated with same firmware version. All NVR must have same username and password. All NVR should have same IP segment for real and virtual IP. All NVR must have same quantity of RAID groups. To prepare the setup, you need a number of main NVR connected to a network switch, and a standby NVR connected to same network. Then you can assign the real IP to all NVR, and prepare a set of virtual IP only for main NVR, which we will configure in cluster configuration. Now let's configure the NVR cluster. Log in NVR which you want to configure as failover NVR. It is recommended to open NVR WebView in Internet Explorer mode in Windows 11. Click Edge Settings. Then select Default Browser. Under Internet Explorer Compatibility, change from Default to Allow. And click Restart. Edge will reload again. Now click Internet Explorer icon to reload the NVR web page in Internet Explorer mode. Toggle on this to open the web page in Internet Explorer mode next time. Click Done to confirm. Now log in NVR by filling the username and password. Now click Settings and navigate to Cluster Service. Under Cluster Service, select Sub-Device. And click Manual Add. Fill the unique name like Failover NVR. You will observe that IP address is already filled and cannot be changed. And it's same as the NVR you are logged in. That's why cluster configuration to be done in Failover NVR. Now fill the password. And click OK to confirm. Now add main NVR. Under main device, click manual add. In device name, give it a unique name, like NVR1. In IP address, fill real IP of NVR1. Fill NVR1 password and finally click OK to confirm. Similarly add more main NVR. Make sure you don't enable cluster IP in failover NVR. It should remain blank. Now click cluster control. And go to arbitrage IP tab. In preferred IP, fill any active IP in CCTV network, like DSS server IP. Alternate IP is optional, you can use IP of one of CCTV workstation. Now click OK to confirm. Finally go to cluster control tab on same page. And click start cluster. Cluster service will start now. To verify, you can check main device page. You will observe, the status of all main NVR is working now. And under sub device, failover NVR status is idle. Now let's add the virtual IP to main NVR. Log in to one of the main NVR. Under settings, navigate to cluster service. Check to enable. And fill virtual IP address, mask and gateway in same range of real IP address. Finally click OK to confirm. You will observe, main and sub device page are exactly same as we configured in Failover NVR. We need to add virtual IP in all other main NVR via same method. Now let's add all main NVR in DSS platform. Open DSS Pro web client in web browser. Login with administrator credential. Click device. Now click add to register NVR manually. In IP address fill NVR1 IP same as you set in NVR1 cluster IP address. Fill NVR1 password here. And click add. In device name, fill a unique name for DSS Pro. Like NVR1. And finally click OK to register this NVR. Click Add again to register balance main NVR with virtual IP. And here we complete the NVR failover configuration. Now let's test the failover function. Run DSS PC client. Login in DSS Pro client. Open live menu and load NVR1 view cameras for live streaming. Now disconnect NVR1 network cable to test failover cluster switching. Once the main NVR is disconnected, cameras shall be offline for less than 2 minutes. Under cluster service of any online NVR, you can observe the status of NVR1. The status will change from working to backup. And the status of failover NVR under sub device will change to in use. During first cluster switch, login in Failover NVR and navigate to camera registration page under settings. You will observe NVR1 cameras are added now in Failover NVR automatically, but all are offline. We need to fill each camera password again, as passwords are not transferred from main NVR. Either we can do it one by one like this. Click Modify per camera. And fill camera password and save individually. There is another way also to fill passwords in batch. Select all cameras and click export. Uncheck for encryption and click OK. Save the remote config CSV file in desired location locally. Browse to remote config file location and open it in MS Excel. Fill all cameras' passwords in password column. Make sure you save this file in CSV format only. Now we will import this file in Failover NVR. Click Import and load the same CSV file which you updated recently. Click Yes to override channels. Within few seconds, all cameras should be online. Click Refresh to update the status. Now in DSS client, you can reload NVR1 cameras in live view. Once the cameras start streaming, you can check playback also. Under home menu, click record playback. And load few cameras from NVR1 for playback. Select record direct to recorder. And finally click search. You should able to play the recent footage now, which is currently recording in Failover NVR. In recording bar, you will observe only recent recording available, which started after Failover switch only. We will switch back to main NVR. Reconnect main NVR in network. And switch to live view now. Once the main NVR is reconnected to network, cameras will switch to main NVR in roughly 30 seconds. You can check the NVR cluster page. The status of Failover NVR shall change from working to idle again. And main NVR1 is now working. Also footage recorded in Failover NVR shall start transferring in main NVR, click transfer record. Under operation, you can find record transfer details. Click refresh to load the recent status. You will find data starts transferring. The transfer time depends on footage duration available in Failover NVR. In meantime, you can check DSS client playback to confirm that main NVR1 is in control now. You will observe now all the recordings are available to play from main NVR1. In recording bar, you will find the recording gap, because record transfer still under progress. You can track the data transfer progress in NVR cluster page. Wait for data transfer to finish. Data transfer is a slow process and may take a while, keep tracking the progress. Once the transfer completes, you can check playback in DSS client. Click search again to refresh the recording bar. This time you will find the recording bar is filled now. Now the gap is only for 2 minutes or less. This 2 minutes gap shall be there only due to switching time, when main NVR switch to failover NVR. You can check more details in cluster logs in NVR. Click search to load recent cluster logs. Click information under details to see logs detailed information. And here we complete NVR failover test also. Thanks for using Dahua products.